yourself out. Don't count yourself out. Don't count yourself out. Because see, sometimes people, we have this mentality that if I don't have this, I'm nothing. But see, that's what the world does, because see, when we flip that TV on to see when someone has committed suicide and things of that nature, they are never connected with the rock. They just went to and fro wherever, and they trusted things that was not any good, that was corrupt. Stick with the one true living God. I don't care how young you are. God has entrusted something in each and every one of you young people. God is really using these young people. If we sit there and see with our spiritual eyes, not the things that they may be doing that may be out of line, because see, that's where we step in with a training process, but to commend them on seeing what God is doing to and through them. They need to hear these things. They need to hear encouragement from us when they do good. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. And see, we need to be in the right position as far as parents, because see, when things do get out of line, the child is not supposed to be telling us what to do. The word says to train them up. But see, somewhere along the line, we have forgot our position as parents, as grandparents, guardians, what have you. We have just gotten out of position, but God says, get back in line and to be ready. To be ready and be in position. Whether it's good or bad, we're responsible for our actions, our thoughts, words, lifestyle, other people, and our prayer life. And our prayer life. Let's, if I may, on Wednesday, Lex came. Reverend Vicki, I got this exam, and SOL, all at the same time. I need you to pray for me, Reverend Vicki. I need you to pray for me. I said, hold up. You can pray.
Amen.
See, that's what the kingdom does. You don't need to go searching after man. See, you need to know what your potential is. See the potential, the responsibilities that God has entrusted you with. That way you won't seek for man when your back gets up against the wall. He has delegated us the authority and the power. Each and every one of us in here. Oh, the birds of the air, fish of the sea, come on. We read it, Genesis 1:26. Do we meditate on it? We have got to know. We have got to know without a shadow of a doubt. Who are you believing in? Who are you believing in? Is man connected to the joy that you have? Last I heard, I couldn't get my joy from the man. I had to get my joy from the source, the one and true living source. Stop connecting your feelings to people and connect it to Christ. And then I told Lex, and she dropped her head and said, yeah, there we go. So we just need to be reminded. We just need to be reminded. That's why I know the Holy Spirit was just going to teach today, because we need to hear these things. We just need to be reminded and reminded continuously. And Max, did your prayers work?
It
passed as well in your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's what we teach the young people. They have the power to pray for themselves. Amen. I'm here to agree. They need me, but I'm not the source. God uses me as a source, but I'm not the source. And as parents and as grandparents, we have to put the responsibility back in God's hands to take care of our young people, our goes a mighty long way. And even the little ones, little ones, Mary, Layla, Christian, all of them, they can all pray. Because they have been influenced by prayer. That same influence is not just for those houses, it's for every house. We have the ability. Amen. No, carry the influence, not just here on Sundays, but everywhere we go. God has entrusted us with keys that serve a purpose in the kingdom of God. Are you using your keys? Are we using our keys?
Amen.
So we need to be responsible and always be ready. Get out of the box.